Good afternoon, my name's Hippyswift and today I'm going to be showing you guys at home a closer look at the Roswheel Attack bikepacking bags. Let's start with the top two bags. On the outside you have a nice little pocket here for puncture repair kit, patches, anything like that. Same with the other side, but on this side it's got a little zip. Not too deep pockets, just enough for some puncture repair slime scabs or some tyre levers, something like that. On the top you can put a pump or a small 4-4.5 inch satellite phone or sat nav type thing. You can put that quite nicely. For the main compartment, opens from the sides. These nice little zips that have put some rather handy toggles on, nice and handy, especially if you're wearing gloves. Inside it has some relatively smooth material for waterproofing this actual bag. It has dividers inside with Velcro. That may annoy you, the Velcro, but you know, always take that out like I do and just put bigger items in there, like if you eat gels or anything, you can put gels in there. Normally I'd fill this up with spare parts or something like that. So yeah, that's a nice little 1.2 litre compartment that. Very nice and large for easy access items and accessories. Moving on to the frame bag itself, you can see a couple of elasticated mesh pockets this side for puncture protection, slime scabs, something like that. On the other side you have about a quarter to half a litre of flat storage space this side for phone, wallet, keys, that type of thing. You can actually see in here it's got another compartment where you can move it all along. You can even get the one out of the top tube and put it in here, just section it off even more if you need to keep things a bit more organized. However, I don't really use them, I just shove loads of things in. And once again, this is waterproofed with a nice soft blue material, very nice and heavy duty. It's all padded all around and I really like it. A great feature of these bags is if you actually undo the bag itself, you can actually have 3/4 of a litre extra storage space for your food, water, or extra kit you're carrying along the way, like extra jacket if you pick one up on cold nights or something like that. But yeah, that does very, very nicely. There's lots of molly or military molly loops under here, so you can just get a couple of these Velcro straps and strap on a couple of water bottle cages that you can get. One here maybe for your methylated spirit for your stove burner. And a water bottle up here, that'll sit roughly just above my other water bottle there. So yeah, very nice and handy, and it's waterproof. One tip I would like to mention is when you get these bags, you'll often find that they come with silica gels like these. Don't chuck these away, keep them in a waterproof bag until your bag gets wet inside. But sometimes you're putting wet clothes and stuff back in your bags when you're taking them off and that type of thing in the wet and rain, which means inside the bag will actually start sweating and producing a bit of condensation in the bag. So after you take the clothes out or hang them on your towel pack to dry out in the wind, you can put a few of these back in the bag, seal it up, and that'll absorb the majority of the moisture on your travels. Finally, you have the Roswheel Attack seat pack. This is apparently 100% waterproof and it's very, very lightweight for the material. I really, really like these. They just open up with a nice click and roll system at the back, attached to these two clips here. My tip for stopping your bag from wiggling about like mad is if you attach the two seat ones over the top of the roll toggle, and then tighten it up a little bit, just pulling the bag up, or use your knee to pull the bag up from the back, and then you can tighten these ones, not too tight, but just tight enough to lift it up into the back, bottom of the seat type thing, so it hugs the seat a bit better, then it won't rock about as much. Apart from being waterproof, the features I like best about this is the actual material of the straps. They're like a fake suede leather, really, really lovely, sticky, almost sticky material. They're absolutely great and they wrap around, they're nice thick. Nice and thick bands that go around and they keep away from your legs so they don't irritate you. There's lots of reflective strips and patches all over this, including reflective striping on the actual elastication bit up here. Some people put a pot and pan set like me on the back here, that'll hug quite nicely. Put that out of the way for now. just so it's not dangling about and making an irritating noise. On the back here is a really good place to put a light. You can simply put a tail light clip through here and then clip your cat eye or moon gemming light right on the back. I use a moon comet variety myself, and this is a really handy idea that a lot of seat pack companies make nowadays. For the front roll bag, you have this. This is a nice little size, absolutely brilliant. There's nice little Velcro strips which the actual dry bag from inside attaches to. I'm not quite sure about the attachment to the handlebars, as it's just a simple wrap and Velcro system which may flap about in the wind a bit on your bike over bumps and that type of thing. It is actually fairly waterproof, this, and I have to say that the dry bag is absolutely spot on. It's not too big. It's about 6 inches diameter, that type of thing. So it's really well made as well, from a heavy duty tarpaulin. And when you actually roll it up, it is really airtight. You can just about fit a two-man tent in it as well. But personally, I always put my cooking equipment and the heavy items at the front of the bike. Again, like the tailpack, there's a little light clip holder at the front of the bike, just so you can put an extra little light there for your safety. Thanks for watching this video. If you like the look of these bags or wish to find out more information, there's going to be links to Amazon and Roswheel website in the description box below this YouTube video. Till next time, stay safe and hope you find peace.